Hello, I'm Jenness Cortez. My painting, entitled The Good Life, was commissioned for the formal dining room of a magnificent new home. The collector's only requirement was the inclusion of Pierre-Auguste Renoir's Luncheon of the Boating Party. Renoir's famous painting is a celebration of a real-life phenomenon. In 1881, Renoir was part of a group of young artists and writers who lived, worked, and played in the suburbs of Paris. He chose one of their favorite gathering spots, the balcony of the Maison Fournaise, a hotel on the River Seine, to host his imagined luncheon. Parisians of the time would have been able to recognize the faces. For instance, the comedian Ellen André sipping wine, the actress Jeanne Samary, who clasps her gloved hands to her ears at the upper right during a conversation with Renoir's friend Paul Lot, the well-known art critic Charles F. Roussy, to whom Renoir owed a debt of gratitude for glowing reviews, appears in his signature top hat at the far end of the balcony. Gustave Caillebeau, Renoir's friend, collector, and a fellow painter, anchors the lower right corner of the composition. And the celebrated actress, known as Mademoiselle Angèle, sits under the attentive gaze of the journalist Antonio Maggiolo. The bare-armed boat rental agent at the left is the hotel owner's son, Alphonse Fournaise, and his sister, Alphonsine, leans on the railing. Note that we see in this gathering a display of the most desirable styles of the moment. It's a function of Renoir's lifelong interest in fashion, born of his parents' work as a dressmaker and tailor in the city of Limoges. To reach its perfection, Luncheon of the Boating Party went through major renovations over a period of many months. Renoir skillfully leads our eye through the complex circular composition, through the arc of portraits into the center still life, and out past the striped awning to the Seine, then back again into the faces and gestures of the happy gathering. The movement is easy, and every part of it is delicious. Although the painting may appear at first glance to be uncontrived, here, as in most of Renoir's work, we see fastidious craft successfully producing exactly the casual look he sought. Such achievement does take long hours of planning and work, but in this particular case, there may be other reasons for the painting's long completion time. In a letter to a patron, Renoir confides that a socialite who had asked to be included in this group portrait then failed to reappear for further sittings after work on her likeness had already begun. Renoir painted her out of the lower left corner and replaced her with a portrait of a playful young seamstress, Aline Chargot, and her dog. This marks the first time that Aline appears in his work. Within that year, he and Aline were married, and she remained his wife and occasional model for 3 decades until her passing. Continuing in Renoir's festive spirit, I chose to create a foreground still life that includes books about the community of artists working along the Seine, and I added a second lyrical Renoir image shown on the open page of the little upright book. That charming painting, entitled Dance at Bourgeois, depicts his friend Paul Lot, again, dancing with the painter Suzanne Valadon at another suburban celebration. I completed my still life with wine, fruit, and flowers, carrying Renoir's favorite themes into the present-day dining room. Now that you know a little more about this famous painting, I hope you'll enjoy it even more the next time you see it. And I hope we'll see you again soon for another episode of Demystifying the Masters.
If you enjoyed this episode of Demystifying the Masters with Jenness Cortez, like it, share it, and subscribe to our channel. If you are an art collector planning to enhance your collection, we invite you to view more of the Cortez work at jennesscortez.com.